for joining me this morning.
I'm Heather Moss, and I'm one of the family ministry leaders here at Caw Prairie Community Church in Lenexa, Kansas. I am so excited. This is the final lesson of our series, Unusual. And I'm going to start by asking you a couple of questions. So first, have you ever had a big change? Maybe at home or at school? Can you name something that never changes? Now that question might be a little bit harder. Change can be really good and awesome, and sometimes change can be really scary and hard. The good news is that there is something that never changes, and we're gonna find out what that is. But before that,
it's time to dance.
He's the way to heaven. 8, 9, 10, sing it again. I can always count on him. I can always count on Jesus. I can always count on Jesus. I can always count on Jesus.
Let's check out these images. I want you to call out what you see. Okay, like these images, there are sometimes situations where we maybe feel differently or have a different opinion than someone else. We might see it completely different. For instance, some might say that God doesn't just care about what we do that's wrong, but he also cares about how we react to people who do things that are wrong to us. That doesn't mean that we should let people hurt us. In fact, it's our special adult's job to keep us safe and healthy. And if someone is hurting us, we should let them know. We want to make sure we're talking about our big feelings, and we don't want to keep it to ourselves if someone is hurting us. But God also wants us to practice forgiveness. Forgiveness of our friends and our family members, even when they sometimes make us mad. So let's try out some scenarios and see how we could maybe deal with them and find a way in our hearts to forgive them. So what if a friend was playing with your favorite toy and they broke it? What could you do? You could forgive them, right? It was probably an accident. How about if there's only one juice box left and your brother takes it without even offering it to you, even though he had the second to last one yesterday? Again, we can forgive. What if your mom promised to take you to the playground on Saturday and she ended up having to work? You know, a lot of times both sides are right. The best way to approach these situations is try to understand where the other person is coming from and ask and offer forgiveness. The good news is that God is always there to forgive us. Unlike these images, that will never change. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Let's check in with Carl and hear how the story's going with David.
Hi there, little chicken nuggets. It's me, Carl.
And it's me, Andy.
Welcome to Grow TV.
Welcome to Grow TV! Hosted by Carl. Where we have fun with our friends, talk about Jesus, and go over everything the Bible has to offer. Now, once again, welcome to Grow TV!
Oh, hey, how's it going?
Good, you seem distracted. What are you working on?
Oh, this? You probably wouldn't be interested.
Okay.
Fine, I'll tell you. It's my no mess up notes.
Your what?
No mess up notes. I put everything I mess up on this notepad. Then I do all I can to not mess up. And this week, I've done a pretty good job.
Wow, that's cool. So can you tell me what's on the list? What aren't you supposed to do?
Well, I mean, I guess, as long as you don't tell anyone.
Promise.
All right, things I didn't mess up this week. Take a shower, wash my face, make my bed, make my dog's bed, sneeze with my eyes open, sneeze with my front door open, sneeze with my car door open, juggle a gerbil, gamble a goose, shuffle a Shamu, tie my shoes, brush my teeth, wrestle a bear, fight a gorilla, tussle the kangaroo, be on time to school, turn in my homework, do my wildebeest impression.
Wildebeest?
Yep.
What's your wildebeest impression?
Oh, well, they have a very unique sound, and I do a really good impression of them. But I've been told that it gets pretty annoying.
Oh, I don't think I've heard it.
Oh, it's great. You'd love it.
All right, then. Let's hear it.
All right.
Wow. That is amazing. Also, I can see how that gets annoying.
Yeah, back to the list.
What? What's wrong?
I messed up!
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did. I was just going over what I haven't done this week, and I just messed up by doing that silly impression.
Oh.
Oh? Oh? Yeah, I just messed up my whole week, man.
Carl, it's gonna be all right. I think you just need to take a breath, relax, and let's jump into today's story.
Fine. Are we still talking about David?
We sure are, and this is a story that really shows just how amazing God really is.
Wow. Well, I'm looking forward to this then.
Well, the story is happening in 2 Samuel, and David is still king of Israel.
Did everyone love him?
The people of Israel adored King David. He was a warrior, and God was very good to David.
Was he still fighting in battles?
He was, but in this story, he stayed back home while his armies went to battle.
Why is that?
I'm not sure if it was because he was getting older, or maybe this specific battle was a small one, or maybe they just didn't need him. But either way, David was at home on his roof.
On his roof? What was he doing?
Just going for a walk, but it was at this moment that he saw a woman named Bathsheba.
That's a funny name.
I guess, yeah. Well, David thought she looked really pretty, and so he had his guards go get her, and David fell in love with her, and she became pregnant.
Oh, that's so cute. Well, what?
The thing is, Bathsheba was married.
Yeah, to David.
Nope.
No. You mean she was married to someone else, and David did what he wanted? Decided to make her his own wife?
Yep.
That's not right.
Not at all.
Well, I mean, maybe you didn't know. I mean, maybe this was just an honest mistake, right? Andy, tell me you didn't know. Tell me you didn't know. Andy.
Well,
again? I mean, he knew? Come on, David.
Yeah, and it gets worse.
How could it possibly get worse?
Bathsheba's husband, Uriah, was a soldier in David's army.
Uh-huh.
And David sent out an order to the general.
Oh, I'm scared to ask. What was the order?
He made sure Uriah was at the front of the group during the battle.
Wait, wouldn't that be like the worst place to be? I mean, he'd probably die.
Unfortunately, that's what David wanted. And sadly, Uriah did die.
That's awful. How could David do that?
David had messed up and he thought this was the best way to fix everything.
Fix everything? He just made it worse. I thought I was messed up, but wow. David made a real big mess of things.
I totally get why you'd say that. You know, we all mess up in different ways, but you know what's unusual? God still loves us.
Not David though, right?
Why would you say that?
What? What David did was so wrong. It's like unforgivable. I mean, I know God loves everyone, but how could God still love David? It's impossible.
Well, I have some news for you, Carl. God did still love David very much. I mean, yeah, David really did make some terrible mistakes and he would have to deal with the consequences of those things later. But God never stopped loving David.
So, God loves us no matter what we do? And there's nothing that we can do to change how much God loves us?
That's right. Nothing can make God love us any more or any less.
Wow, that definitely makes me feel better about messing up because I know God's love is unchangeable.
Hey, Carl, that's our big idea. Today's big idea is God's love is unchangeable. So let's say it out loud on the count of three. One,
two,
three.
God's love is unchangeable. Yeah.
Unchangeable like my pants. I've never changed them. But it's like fine cheese, you know, the longer you age them and don't touch them, the better they become. Well, I learned a lot this month. What a unusual and unlikely story David had.
I'm glad. So what are you going to do with that notebook?
I'll probably get rid of it. Kind of smells like Up Dog anyway.
What's Up Dog?
Not much. What's up with you?
I can't believe you fell for that.
Look who fell now. All right, we'll see you next time, kids.
Thank you for watching, and tune in next week for a new episode of Road TV.
All right, let me ask you a question. Have you ever found yourself in a place where you shouldn't be? Well, that's what happened in our Bible story today. King David wasn't exactly where he was supposed to be, and it kind of got him into some trouble. So I have another question for you. Have you ever saw something that you really, really wanted and you just had to have it, but you knew that it would hurt someone if you took it? Well, that's exactly the position that David was in. And guess what? He didn't make a great choice. David was supposed to be with the rest of his troops in battle, but he decided to stay home. And then one day he noticed a woman named Bathsheba, and he thought she was so beautiful that he decided he was in love with her. But there was a problem. Bathsheba wasn't available. She was already married to another man named Uriah. But David, he cared more about his feelings than Uriah's feelings, even though he knew he might be hurt. He didn't even know if Bathsheba felt that way. So he tried a bunch of different things to make Uriah go away, but nothing seemed to work. So one bad decision led to another until David made the worst decision of all. He sent Uriah into battle knowing that he would be killed. Even though David messed up big time, God still didn't abandon him. Of course, David would have to face the consequences for his poor choices, but God still loved him, and he didn't even take away his promises that he had made for his future. God's love for David stayed the same. Let's see what Sparky has to say today.
Hey, Sparky, how are you? You seem a little down. Are you okay?
I'm a fraud, Miss Aaliyah.
A fraud? Why are you a fraud? Why do you say that?
I'm a terrible person, too.
No.
I cheated.
What?
I know.
On your ACTs?
No. Oh. Okay, you know we went to the state championship for toe lifting?
Yeah, the toe lifting. I remember that.
They had a rule. Look at my arm. They said no sweatbands. But I never compete without my lucky sweatbands.
You've talked about that before.
They're what makes me a winner.
A winner? Okay.
So I just wore them and I won. And now I'm a terrible person and God probably doesn't like me because I cheated.
Sparky, it's okay. I mean, it's not okay to break the rules, but I can tell you this, that God still loves you. It's okay. And you know what? God has always loved you and he's going to continue to love you no matter your mistakes or what happens. And he'll just keep loving you. And God's love is bigger than what we can imagine. And the love that God has for you and me and them will never, ever, 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 ever change.
Really?
Really. Actually, we've kind of already talked about that. We could talk about some more, and Carl's already mentioned it too. So the big idea this week, if you're ready to share with our friends, because they've already heard it once, but let's go ahead and repeat it just for them. Are you ready?
Oh, well, yeah, but the kid's going to tell us, right? We're going to listen or what?
No, you're going to tell us.
Oh, okay, I'm going to do it. I always get confused on this part.
It's okay. So we can read it together. Should we, like, dramatic? And should we, like, do a drum roll?
Yes,
should we
just, like... I like drum rolls.
Just, you know what? Let's just count it off. Are we going to do two or three?
Three.
Okay. Are you ready? One, two, three.
God's love is unchangeable.
So just like I said, no matter what, forever and ever, and it's not going to change. It's unchangeable.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Thank you so much for joining me this morning. Be sure to check out the KP website for additional discussion questions and activities that you can do as a family. Our YouTube channel, Facebook page, and Instagram page are covered with content for you to check out all this week. Before you go, let's go over our memory verse one more time. Let's see if you have it memorized. Say it with me. It's Isaiah chapter 55, verse 8 in the NIV version. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Now let's watch a quick video on how to do the sign language. See if you can do it along with us.
Isaiah 55, 8. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord.
Awesome job, everyone. Memorizing scripture is one of those ways that we can stay connected with God, and prayer is one way we can do that too. So before you go today, let's pray together. Dear God, your love is always there, even when we make mistakes. Your unchanging love helps me to be forgiven and to experience a new life. Thank you for giving us everything we need. Help us to be examples of your unchanging love. Amen. All right, guys, have a great week. Next week, we're going to have an all new series and an all new host. So come back and check it out. You're not going to want to miss it. See ya.